In this video, you will see how to streamline shipping of your orders using Shipping Data Entry in the Starship module. Shipping Data Entry separates the packing and shipping functions performed in the warehouse from the accounting functions of invoicing normally performed in the business office of your company. At the Shipper ID field, I enter my unique Shipper ID number and notice that the date field defaults to the current system date. I use a barcode scanner to scan the number of the order I want to ship from the picking sheet. You can see that all of the items on the order appear automatically. You'll also notice that we go directly to the Lines tab first, with the Shipping tab second. This design promotes speed and efficiency of warehouse workers and lets them start scanning items right away. I'm going to scan the barcode label of the item. You'll notice that, regardless of the sequence I use to scan the items, the system finds the item on the order. Each time I scan a product, the quantity increments by one. You can also see that the current package I am using is package 1. To make it easy to go to the next package, Best created a barcode that automatically increments the package by 1. I simply scan that barcode and my package number changes automatically. So I'll put the rest of the items in the second package. But I see that the next line has a quantity of 15. So rather than scan all of those items individually, I'll turn off the automatic increment feature and key in the quantity. And since the next item is a serial item, the lot serial distribution panel pops up automatically so I can distribute the quantity. Once I'm finished with the line entry, I click to go to the Shipping tab. But I get a message telling me that all lines aren't resolved. This means I have to make certain that the quantity shipped plus the quantity backordered equals the quantity ordered. The message gives me an opportunity to backorder the unresolved line, which I will do. So now we will say that the order is ready to ship because all lines have been resolved. When we move over to the Shipping tab, we notice that the ship freight amount is 0. We click on the Starship icon to activate the Starship link and bring up the Starship Current Manifest screen. Notice that the screen design is very similar to Mass 90 and that our recipient's name, address, and contact information has flowed from the Mass 90 order, as has the preferred shipping method. Near the magnifying glass at the top of the page, you can see that this is package number 1 of 2. I place the first box on the integrated scale, and the package weight appears in the weight field. The package service cost and shipment total fields are calculated for the first package and appear on the bottom left of the screen. If I use the next arrow key to move to package 2 and place it on the scale, the package service cost for this package appears and the shipment total increments by that amount as well. I then print my UPS shipping labels onto a thermal label printer from Starship. Once the labels are printed, we're finished in Starship, so can save the record by pressing the icon in the toolbar. The link now takes us back to Mass 90 into the Summary Package Tracking Maintenance screen. A quick glance at each of the entries shows that the weight and freight charges calculated by Starship have been written back to Mass 90. Notice, too, that the package tracking number appears as well. Clicking Accept in Package Tracking Maintenance takes us back to the shipping panel of Shipping Data Entry, where we can see the total freight amount has been added to the entry. Clicking Accept on this screen starts the automatic printing of packing lists, since we chose that option in Setup. As you can see, I have selected to print crystal reports for my packing list printing to allow crisp professional forms. First comes the master packing list, which shows everything on the order and the total number of packages in the order. Next, the additional packing lists print. First, you see the additional packing list for the initial package, where my original 2 items were placed. It is followed by the packing list for the second package, showing the items we packed there. Once the packing lists are finished, I am right back in Shipping Data Entry, ready to pack and ship another order. As you can see, Mass 90 and Mass 200, combined with Starship, provide a powerful and streamlined shipping process designed for maximum efficiency in your warehouse.